So I'm just trying to keep up with the other question we've asked earlier. We have a little more to hand up first, but
just a brief and maybe the cannot be on bills and there, but one of the things I can't do is time travel. So we've
only you spotted it.
It's June 2016, the right place. Does that mean I've got to travel back in time?
I wouldn't let you do that, it should be to June 2017.
Okay, so that says we'll probably try and have a decision. Okay, who can back on this here?
I'll just ask a question on 3.5. If the Cllr insurance are used in the market, how do you assess the quality?
Quality is a very big element of the process. And a big element of that for two elements. One is the actual breadth of the policy cover, and the other element is the quality of the claims handling. That is actually critical in terms of what we ultimately pay. In terms of the quality of the cover, we get a report from our brokers, which is supplemented by our own revision of the policy wordings. And there is obviously a score allocated to that. In terms of the quality of the claims handling, we actually go out and interview the claims handlers on site. We look at their systems, we fire technical questions at them, and that is a key part of the evaluation. In fact, it's a critical element from our perspective. We feel that the new provider haven't seen all the policy papers that have been produced by my strategy team colleagues, so I answer that. I don't have the answers to that. But it works on the other way.
Was that a rhetorical question, John?
No, I just wonder why. What made you consider them as the way that both the cars are? I only have the cars. Perhaps there are any
problems. Yeah. Sure, the room is
is it both regularly, for members who've been on committee in one off, we used to have a lot of grant claims that were audited by the external auditors, but now they're basically gone. So if I get a detailed report, now we get a letter. The claim is outstanding, is a significant one, the county benefit, subsequent claim. You see down there the value of that claim was last year's £137 million. It's now been subject to external audit. The resulting outcome found a few issues that were raised, but the main finding was because of the increased £1,400 on the result of the audit. The details are set out in Appendix A of that one, and to point out the audit fee for that was £24,920. So I present that on behalf of Council and colleagues in Cllr Ron Abbey. We involve the interview cost to present that. It's just essentially this leading some information. It's part of concluding their audit. Seen. There's one around we have to assume two certificates.
normally you mark that for a pension fund, and you'll know different than that because we know where the income's coming from, it's when you didn't earn from your own asset. So, and you have good process and arrangements with council, so we normally rebut that one. Where, so we don't have to do specific work on that. We are required to look at assume fraudulent management override controls. That's nothing to do with your officers. We are required to assume that that happens, and if so, respond to that risk. And we normally do that to through looking at journals, because that's the way that any information the council would be potentially hidden. So that's what we're doing through that. And then the key area probably for the fund is area where it's harvested value is those level three investments and private equity ones.
And as I live close to the Clatterbridge site, I'm reporting daily of that little road by Clatterbridge Hospital. Can we have, is it possible to have covert surveillance of all the places where we could name, and every one of us around this table could name in our own wards where the fly tipping goes on?
The short answer is correct, is yes, but of course resources are limited. It may be difficult for the enforcement officers to undergo covert surveillance at multiple sites. You have to concentrate on the more sites where the serious problems are occurring. But in principle, yes, as you can clearly bring to the attention of the enforcement officers, sites where fly tipping is occurring, and no doubt priority will be given to those sites.
I ask because even though one recent tipping at Clatterbridge had documents which all pertained to a certain company and individual, as I'm aware no action was taken because there's no proof that that person tipped the rubbish. And I think that's almost as ridiculous a situation as David's referring to in here.
Training event, and I've very nearly forgotten.
send an email out sort of 5 days a week, but literally just 2 days in fact, that sort of 26th is the day we'll be earmarked at this moment in time. 26th, yeah, the afternoon of the 26th. I'll send an email out, a bit like